First of all, we have a quarterly startup afternoon, which we invite corporates, investors and startups to meet up. We arrange in that session over 350 speed dates for startups this year, offering them access to capital and markets, not only with KPN but also with partners outside KPN. Secondly, we have our field labs. We have five 5G field labs, creating customer customer projects together with partners, as well as we have an innovation playground where we open up our network possibilities, as well as our security labs for startups to experiment there. And thirdly, we arrange challenges, for example, a CISO challenge on risk monitoring tooling, or a challenge with the UMCG on e-health. Hans?
On top of that, this year we have evaluated over 2,600 innovative companies, and we focus on innovation areas like IoT, cybersecurity, networking technology, smart home, and cloud solutions.
And finally, we're into knowledge sharing on how to work with startups. This prize is one where we are happy to share our knowledge. But in Holland, we also have the Costa team, which is a group of over 20 corporates exchanging knowledge on how to work with startups. And finally, we do co-creation sessions. These are sessions where the things in the supply chain get stuck. And we open it up by setting all the different parties in the supply chain in a one-day workshop and find solutions for problems which were hard to crack without that solution. So open innovation is our credo, I think. Actually, we have five criteria for that. First of all, for early stage innovations, it's based on validated hypothesis. Secondly, on later stage innovations, it's based on revenue generated. And finally, thirdly, we count the number of successful partnerships realized during the year, both in POC and in structural cooperation phase.
And for our portfolio companies, we have an NPS score, so Net Promoter Score, on how happy they are that we are their shareholder and are helping them to grow fast. And the second one is on financial terms, which is the IRR, so the return we make on our investments. That's it. So as per our new innovation and partnerships team, we now have our innovation agenda being set at board level. There are six strategic innovation themes, and board members are being assigned for each innovation theme. So within this new team, innovation and partnerships are ever more combined and strengthened. So first of all, there hasn't been too much change to our strategy. We continue to focus on partnerships. For KPN Ventures, we of course did have a big impact due to COVID on our portfolio companies. So we supported them all the way, and we supported them also financially to bridge the COVID era. Not specifically related to COVID, we have set up a new innovation and partnerships team. This team is now responsible to set the agenda on innovation and to support innovation by six themes, also sponsored by the Board of Management.
Yeah, and the thing that has changed mostly, I think, is that from physical meetings, we skipped everything to online, and we keep working on finding great innovative companies with challenges within KPN. And I think we even did higher numbers last year than years before. So we managed. First of all, it's network innovations. Secondly, it's IoT and 5G, which is a big area. Thirdly, it's on e-health, digital health. Privacy and security is an important theme. Data and analytics is relevant, and the post-COVID living and working. So we're actually present on a lot of topics which could be new revenue generators.